joined by Hobart head coach Stephen Thompson and athlete Isaiah Washington. We'll open up with a statement from coach, followed by a question for the student athletes. Please state your name and affiliation before your question. Coach?
Yeah, I'll just start by first congratulating Christopher Newport, Coach McCorian. Obviously, a tremendous program. I've known him for a while. My first time matching up against him was 2009 when I was a freshman. He was the head coach at Merchant Marine, so I have a lot of respect for what he's been able to do consistently throughout his coaching career. And they played better than us today, so you tip your cap to their opponent. And I'm still proud of our team as well. I thought we had a great season, a great journey. That's why we were in the NCAA tournament. Didn't play our best ball today when we needed it, but still ultra proud of our team, especially guys like Isaiah, Ryan, Matt, our seniors, who've committed a lot to our program. And can't thank those guys enough.
Seemed like it took maybe a little longer than you would have liked for guys to adjust out being called at the beginning, very physical game. Did it match what you guys were expecting coming in?
I thought so. I think we're a physical team, so are they. And the refs allowed us to play a little bit earlier than we expected. I know Coach McCord is probably saying a couple of his guys had fouls, so you take it for what it's worth. But the game was pretty handsy. Guys were dropping shoulders into the chest. But it's NCAA tournament basketball. People's seasons are on the line. You got to expect that people are going to be fighting to the death, right? As you mentioned, it did take us a little bit to adjust to that. And as a result, we kind of chased them the whole game. You can see they left for 39 minutes. So that's on us for not getting control of the game and being able to make them chase us.
Did you guys talk at all about the game that was supposed to be in the COVID year, or is that too far back to worry about this game?
Our coaches did, but these guys weren't even here. Isaiah was a senior in high school when that was happening, so if I would have told that, he would have had no idea what we were referencing. But that's kind of a unique basketball god, shining the light on both these programs to compete in the NCAA tournament, and that's just kind of how the game works out sometimes.
I just want to clarify, because senior doesn't mean a ton anymore. How many guys are graduating and done, and how many?
We have three: Isaiah, Ryan, Lucy, and Matt Bray.
Isaiah, what? Thoughts on the game? Did it go the way you guys were expecting in terms of style? And did they provide you anything that was surprising?
No, I think coming in, we knew that they're a physical team. They crashed the boards hard. We knew that they're going to try to get down them on offense. So I think they did what we expect them to do. I think they're going to just get a little better job being more physical and executing and boxing out.
One of the seniors, obviously, you're moving on, but there's a lot of young guys who got a lot of minutes. What does this mean for them to get this experience and kind of talk about the legacy you're leaving for them to carry on?
I think this game, and not only this game, but just our whole season has been a great experience for our young guys. They've had a lot of exposure to not only the NCAA tournament, but also the Liberty League tournament, which we won, which was awesome. And I know a lot of young guys have gotten serious minutes and sort of made their way into the lineup. And I think going forward next year, they'll be a little more mature, a little more poised in these situations. So I think this year was a great experience.
What's your degree in? Do you have plans yet for what's happening after graduation?
Yeah, so my degree is in environmental studies and I'm minoring in management. And post graduation, I'm not sure yet, but I want to pursue a career in general business or consulting.
I'll give you a chance to talk about your coach and your years at Hobart since your last game.
Yeah, so my years at Hobart were a little unorthodox. My freshman year of college, I wasn't on the team. I was at Rutgers University taking classes online because of COVID. Yeah. Completely virtual, living from home. Then I transferred to Hobart, walked on the team. And Coach Steph, he didn't guarantee me anything. He said, you can come in, work hard, and try to earn a spot. And that's what happened. The rest is history. But I'll be forever grateful and thankful for Coach Steph giving me this opportunity. In the past 3 years have been nothing short of a blessing. So I've learned a ton. And I really just owe a lot of thanks to Coach Steph here.
Do you have a chance to talk about your seniors as they go?
Yeah, they all have a unique journey, as Isaiah mentioned about his. Matt Brand coming from a very storied program in Archbishop Stepanak, and Ryan came from a good local program in Fairport High School. They came to our campus, those two, without a season their freshman year. So had about 50 or 60 practices under their belts, but no competitions. And basically, their sophomore year was kind of a little bit of a freshman learning experience for them. They didn't get the games and reps and all that, and continue to keep their head down and work. The best thing about those guys is that they were able to build out some good kind of resume experiences outside the court too. All three guys, Isaiah, Matt, Ryan, maximize why you go to a place like Omar. And Matt's got a nice job set up. Isaiah's got a couple options on the table, same with Ryan. But those guys have done an amazing job leading throughout our program. They're our three captains. The reason why we've had success this year is because of these guys. They've made coaching a little bit easier on me, so I'll be forever thankful to them. The best thing about our program, I feel like, is it's a lifelong commitment. So these two are going to be coming back to Alumni Weekend and you know, getting together when their young professional lives are going. So I'm very, very excited to see where they take their lives, but I can't thank them enough for everything they give to Hobart Basketball and their college in general.
Thanks, guys.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.